Well, Eddie, I hesitate to say for sure, but I think we might have just about gotten away with it. We slept the night, and when we woke up, no one was coming out and shouting about, "Get that guy! Stop thief!" You know, none of that. So either nobody noticed our little nocturnal raid on Alice McLafferty's business, or no one cares enough to stop us. I'm hoping it's the first, because that means that the Crimson Caravan is probably going to stay on side. Unfortunately, the Crimson Caravan being on side isn't as useful as I'd hoped. I mean, yes, they're an excellent commercial contact, but what they have in mercantile expertise, they lack in military might. So even if we did a lot of work for them and got them on side, I doubt they'd be storming Vegas with us. Which means we need to look to other corners. Now, we are standing right next to Freeside, so that shouldn't be an issue. I know that What's-His-Face back at Helios 1 said to go check out the old Mormon fort in Freeside, right? And we checked out the clinic, they sold us a whole bunch of mods, a whole bunch of implants. So hopefully, we should be able to check them out. But before we do that, I want to go talk to the locals, you know, kind of get the lay of the land. Make sure I understand who all is... Make sure I understand who the power players are in Freeside. That way, when we go to assault Vegas and kill Benny for shooting us in the head, we're not entirely hosed. Because, no offense, but, we are four guys. Four guys in a van. And it's a very nice van, and we're very nice people, but we're still just four guys. I'm just trying to think. Eddie, you're a robot, there's no disguising that. Boone, you look like an NCR Ranger, that's good. I mean, it gives us an air of panache, of expertise, of don't mess with us. I look, not like an NCR Ranger, like an off-brand one. It's like, people looking at me probably won't know the difference. And Raul, you're in combat armor. It's like, I don't know. People shouldn't mess with you. It's like you're in combat armor and you have a big, big gun on your hip. And now I've got Marty Robbins running through through my brain. It doesn't matter. Let's go find a peasant. Let's go donate to him and get him to tell us what he knows about the area. So this is Freeside, is it? I'm not sure what I was expecting, but I somehow feel underwhelmed. It's like, this is the area immediately surrounding New Vegas, the pristine jewel of the Mojave Desert, and it's, well, it's a dump. It's a slum. It's like we have children chasing each other around with no parents that I can see. We have bombed out buildings. We have a beggar. Hello, sir. You happen to be exactly what I was looking for. Hello. Yes, sir. Rotface. Raul, you're a ghoul. Is that racist? If that's your name, that's your name, I guess.
Hey, buddy, spare a cap? I can make it worth your while.
You know, that's exactly what I was hoping. Wait a minute. This is Vegas. Is this a sex thing?
Ha, ha, ha. Oh, that's rich. You're not exactly my type. No offense. No, I meant I could give you a tip. Earn my money, so to speak.
That still sounds like a sex thing.
You look like you're new around here, so I'm sure I know all sorts of things you'd find useful. If not, well, it's only a cap. So what do you say?
You know, you make a really compelling argument. All right, give me just the tip.
The first thing you should know is that Freeside is run by a pack of yahoos that call themselves the Kings. Their leader, who oddly enough calls himself the King, currently has his hands full trying to prevent an all-out riot in Freeside. That's two tips, but what the hell? You're a new customer, so the extra one's on me. Wanna hear another?
You know what? Sure, that's actually a really good tip. We have a gang in charge, and a problem that we can solve. What's the riot about, though, I wonder? Do you know that? Could you tell me that?
At the northwest end of Fremont Street, you'll find the Silver Rush. It's run by a rather scary family called the Van Graffs. These are not people you want to mess with. But if lasers and such are your thing, the goods they sell are second to none.
A person who sells energy weapons. Do you know how long I've been looking for this? It's like, you go to the Gunrunners, they have plenty of bullets, but no energy ammo. You go to, you know, the 188, you have plenty of bullets, but no energy ammo. You go to Mojave Outpost, you know what they have? It's bullets, and not energy ammo. Finally, someone who sells the right stuff. Yes, yes, finally, okay. I think that trumps the Kings. We need to go check them out. Okay, if the next one is, you know, of that same standard, I'll tell you what, I'll give you two caps.
The chairman run a casino on the strip called The Tops. It's a pretty classy place by all reports. I haven't been there myself, but I hear security there is kinda tight.
Kinda tight in what way? Like, kinda tight in a way that would prevent, you know, just to list a hypothetical, four people from coming in and shooting the boss. It's like, that kinda tight? That's unfortunate. I mean, we're definitely gonna have to figure out some kind of way to get our guns in there to shoot Benny, but it's like, this might be a larger stake than I was thinking. All right, give me another one.
Saw a strange thing the other day. The King took that robo-dog of his over to the old Mormon fort. Weird thing was that the dog was flipping out and had to be restrained by a few of the King's men. Hope he doesn't get loose.
That actually is a really good tip, because now we have two things that the King wants. His robo-dog... Something to happen to the robo-dog? What, like, took it, like, what, does he need to get spayed or neutered? Yeah, give me another one.
People in Freeside generally fall into one of two categories. Those who've been here all their lives call themselves locals. When people from the NCR and other places started pouring in, the locals began referring to them as squatters, and the name stuck. The locals blame the squatters for the scarcity of resources in Freeside, and the squatters blame any act of violence against them on the locals. They're both right to some extent, and violent outbreaks between the two are all too common these days.
Ah, okay, I think I have a better picture on why the King is trying to keep down a riot in Freeside. I mean, I can kind of understand where the... Did you say that they're called the locals? Locals versus squatters. I can kind of understand where they're coming from. It's like, if you have just enough to scrape by and then suddenly hundreds of people start pouring in, dumping money in the casino and then giving nothing to Freeside, and then sticking around after they've lost all their money, yeah, that could be a bit of an issue. Okay, give me another one.
If you've been around the Kings, you may have met one of them named Pacer. He's always stomping around trying to show off his authority. Being new, you weren't around when it happened, but a few months ago, Pacer pissed off the Van Graaff family big time. No one knows what went down, but word is the Van Graaffs still want him dead.
Oh man, this guy is just a gold mine. It's like, we have two gangs, and one of them hates the other, so even if we can't get one of them on side, we might be able to get the other one on side by playing one against the other, saying, hey, Pacer, you know, what do you know? The Van Graaff said they need something from you. Go over there and get shot. Ooh, I like this plan. Okay, here you go.
The Strip is run by the three families who owe their allegiance to Mr. House. When he first showed up, he gave the local tribes the choice of working with him or getting the hell out of his way. Given how things turned out, I know which way I'd have gone. But hindsight's 20/20, right? The Omertas, one of Mr. House's three families, run a casino called Gamora on the Strip. If you thought the Wrangler was something, you owe it to yourself to go there.
What exactly is the Wrangler? It's like, yeah, of course I want to check out the hotels and the casinos on the Strip, but the Wrangler? I don't think I've been there before.
There's a guy out on the main drag who sells secondhand adventuring gear. He's got an okay selection. But where does it come from?
It comes from dead bodies. It's like, that's what happens. You go out into the waste, you find dead people, you take their stuff, you sell it. That way all the stuff they're selling goes back into the economy. You know, caps change hands. It's part of a healthy system, is people dying.
Hey, listen. I'd love to sell you some more info, but you've tapped everything I've heard lately. Come back in a few days. I'll put my ear to the ground and hopefully have heard a few more things by then.
Well, I have to say, that was, you know, 15 caps well spent. It's like, now we have a picture of the politics in the region. We have locals versus squatters, we have the kings, we have a family who sells energy weapons. Holy crap, you guys, we need to go check them out right now. It's like, I know I shouldn't be so geeking out right now, but it's energy weapons, man. It's like, do you have any idea how rare that stuff is? I think I told you, but it's like, they're the only ones I found who have a reliable supply. I can actually buy all the ammo in the world and change it into good it's like, my ammo worries are solved. I can blow through ammo like nothing else, because if I have the caps, I have the ammo. Oh, this is brilliant. Okay, we have our destination. We need to go find these Van Graffs and talk to them and say, hey, what, oh. You guys, please shoot them. Thank you. See, I'd love to use my energy weapons, but when I do that, people kind of explode, and so it just seems safer this way. What the heck? These guys, they had crowbars, and they just said, hey, look at those guys in heavy combat armor and the robot with the laser. Let's attack them. It's like, am I weird for thinking that's a dumb idea? It's like, what? I'm very confused right now. It's like these guys are death incarnate, I'm gonna be honest, and they just, we have two crowbars, we can take them. Hello, Neon. That's interesting. I'm definitely gonna have to check that out real quick.
We've got stuff we're not even allowed to sell, people. Only at Mick and Ralph's.
Stuff you're not allowed to sell? It's like, I could be wrong, but it seems like that's a bad idea to blurt out. It's like, oh, we sell contraband. It's like, really? That's your pitch? Like, we sell contraband. Come check us out. We're totally not doing anything illegal. Ah. I'm betting that would, in fact, be the home of, you know, potentially, the kings. It's like, I'm not 100% sure, but I've got a bit of a hunch. The King's School of Impersonation. I'm guessing you guys with the leather jackets are going to be the kings. The leather jackets and the identical hairstyles. Okay, that's interesting. But we're not after the king, right now at least. We're after the Van Graffs. Ah, the Silver Rush, that's what they said. Oh, it's like, I'm visiting energy weapons Mecca. Hello, Silver Rush. Hello, energy weapons. Oh, you have a plasma rifle.
Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to the Silver Rush, New Vegas' best source of laser and plasma weapons.
From what I can tell, the only source of laser and energy weapons.
Afraid I'm going to have to search you before letting you in. The only weapons allowed on the premises are the ones we're selling.
Oh, but I was planning on selling some of them to you. You know, I have valuable commodities that I can trade for bullets, right? Please?
It should only take a moment. There, I've stowed all of your weapons. You're clear to enter. When you leave, I'll hand them all back to you.
The bosses are having a meeting. You'll have to wait until it's over.
Oh, okay, but I'm here to trade, man.
Mr. Soren, please get to the point. The second half of your payment is late, and I want to know why.
Miss Van Graff, my associates and I have decided that we wish to renegotiate the terms of our deal.
Might I ask for what reason? The shipment was delivered. The guns were tested before leaving this facility.
Regardless, we feel that the quality of the weapons is below expectation and hope to adjust the price accordingly.
Ah, I think I understand what the issue here is. Excuse me for a moment, would you? Jean-Baptiste, could you bring out the volunteer?
What? Volunteer? Still, that guy's kind of a sleazeball. It's like, hey, the weapons were good, but not good enough, so could we cheap out on, you know, without telling you? I mean, that's kind of a dick move. You always
can see them.
I don't even have guns. What do you want me to... What are we going to do? Slap you to death? Yeah, that's... There's a naked guy, Raoul. What's going on? He's tied up.
Is this a lesson, sex thing? Mr. Soren, a lesson in faith.
What is this, Miss Van Graff? I don't understand. Who is this man? What does this have to do with our deal?
Everything. Up until recently, this man was an employee of mine. He's quite handsome, don't you think? I know I did. We became close. I warned him that I was a very jealous woman, and he said he understood. Apparently he didn't. Last week, I chanced upon him in Gamora, being serviced by one of their two-cap whores. I was not pleased. I tell you all this because I want you to know that this man means a great deal to me. Do it.
Oh!
Never break faith with the Van Graffs, Mr. Soren. I expect you'll have the rest of our payment ready tomorrow morning. Okay, everyone. Show's over. Back to work.
I think he wet himself before he left. That was pretty good making up that part about sleeping with Jacob. You did make that part up, right, Glory? Damn it, girl. What has Mama always said about tipping the help? I thought this was about him stealing money from us.
He was stealing money, though he could have kept it for all I cared. God knows he earned it.
Okay. This is a bad idea. This is a really bad idea. We should not be here. But look at all the good stuff. Look at all the energy weapons, Moon. They're the only people who supply energy weapons. Oh, no. She's a psychopath. But she has energy weapons. Hello? Gloria, was it?
Welcome to the Silver Rush, where only top-of-the-line energy weapons can be found. What can I do for you?
Yeah, I'd like to see what you have for sale first.
Of course.
Because what you have will determine whether or not we continue to do business with you. 200 electron charge packs. 135 microfusion cells. Oh, I'm in heaven. Oh. Yes. It's like, yes, you're a psychopath. But you have energy weapon ammo. And energy weapons. An autogauss. The heck is that? 65 damage. And it fires fast as hell. Gatling laser. Gauss minigun. For 3,000 caps. Oh, that looks beautiful. Oh. Oh, that looks amazing. A plasma caster. Oh, I'm in heaven. A tri-beam laser rifle. 70 damage per shot. Oh, that's beautiful. Thor. 25,000 caps. But it does 267 damage per shot. Oh, my word. Oh, we're gonna be so poor when we walk out of here. Oh, and I don't even have any weapons to sell her to allay the cost. Oh, no. Oh, this is terrible. Oh, but she has energy weapons, and it's so nice. Oh, no. Oh, this is so, so beautiful, but so painful. 21,000 caps. Oh, it's beautiful. Now then, about that little display we just had, the hell. Why don't you tell me your opinion on Freeside? It's like, where do you think you guys sit in the power structure here?
This place is certainly lively, that's for sure. Did you want to know something specific about it?
Yeah, I heard you and the kings have had a bit of a tiff in the past. What was that?
The rulers of Freeside. The kings are a bunch of boys who refuse to grow up, and this is their playground. Their leader seems different, though. The few times I've dealt with him, I've been impressed, despite myself. Unfortunately, he rarely acts. The kings believe that everyone in Freeside can do whatever they want, provided they can back it up with force. Which suits us just fine. When we first arrived in Freeside, the kings protested when we kicked out the original occupant of this establishment. When we reduced several of their members to glowing puddles of goo, their objections vanished. Since then, we've left each other alone.
Okay, so not so much a simmering bot. Okay, so it's not so much resentment or out-and-out gang warfare between the two of you, because it seems almost like you guys are too powerful for them to bother. Not too powerful to bother with, but too powerful for them to have an effect on. Oh, I think I'd have my new allies. Okay, and I've heard the followers are here too, right? I think I walked past their fort, right?
I don't really have much to do with them. They seem to have an aversion to weapons technology, and those who possess a great deal of it. Their loss, really.
Right? It's like energy weapons. They're so cool. They're professional. They scream, "Hi, I'm dangerous. Hire me." And is there anything else to do around here besides, you know, squabble over the locals and the squatters?
Well, you probably noticed the Atomic Wrangler across the street. That's pretty much the place to go around here. They make it a little loud around here at night, but the business their proximity brings more than makes up for it. Other than them, you're better off skipping Freeside entirely and just heading to the Strip.
You might think so, but you see, I have some business to conduct in the Strip, and so I need to have a fallback point is what I need. All right, something else.
Suits me. What did you have in mind?
Yeah, tell me about... is this a family business?
Yes, it is. My brother and I run this particular branch, but our family has operations all over, particularly in California.
Okay, and what about you?
Oh, there's not much to tell. I was born into a big family and don't get along with my parents, so here I am, as far away from them as possible.
I suppose I can understand that. And I imagine that you and the Gunrunners, well, probably haven't come to blows, but you're probably competing one against another.
There are chief competitors in this region and many others. That makes them our enemies. While I respect their business acumen, I'm obligated to try to destroy them however I can. That's business, after all.
Ooh, not just competitors, enemies. You, madam, are a dangerous lady. Okay, and what do you know about Mr. House? I mean, I'm gonna have to deal with him sooner or later, because he's in the Strip. And if things go wrong, he and I might come to blows when I kill Benny. What do you know about him?
Very little, same as everyone else. We attempted to deal with him when we first moved into the area, but had no luck. He must have his own weapons supplies to keep as many laser-armed robots operational as he does. Makes me wonder where they are.
Ooh, maybe he has a factory. I mean, could you imagine? It's like, that will be worth going after. It's like, oh, sorry, this is mine now. All the energy weapons ammo in the world. Okay. And here's the important question. I want to work for you guys.
It just so happens a position opened up recently. We currently need another body to guard the entrance outside. Think you can handle that?
Yeah, I can do that. Count me in.
Wonderful. I already have a man outside who can show you the ropes and get you set up. His name is Simon. He's been with the family for years, so listen to what he says and follow his instructions.
Okay. I mean, I was hoping something more, well, not glamorous, but more mobile than a guard position. It's like, I was hoping to be able to, you know, I don't know. I don't want to be tied down to a building. I need to be able to roam and sell stuff and kill people and take their stuff and so I can sell that. Now then, Simon, is it?
Welcome to the Sylve. Aw, crap. Don't tell me you're my new guard.
What do you mean, aw, crap? Do you think I'm not capable enough? Yeah, that's right.
Well, no time for pleasantries. I've got your gear right here, but let's see if you can follow instructions. You'll be covering the other side of the door there. Take your position while I get your stuff out.
Okay. Guys, go ahead and relax, all right?
Okay, now let's get you geared up. First, your armor. Standard issue is your run-of-the-mill combat armor, with a nice dark coat of paint for both brand recognition and sheer intimidation value. Next, your weapon. Guards are required to use rifles. Anything lighter compromises your combat effectiveness. Anything heavier and people are too scared to come in the door. What's your preference, laser or plasma?
You know, normally I'd say plasma, but I've gotten a Gatling laser recently and it's winning me over a bit. Let's go for laser.
Good choice. I prefer laser-based weapons myself, but the boss lady says she wants at least one guard using a plasma rifle. Says the lightning bits draw in more people. Whatever. Now that you're equipped, a quick word on the job at hand. In a nutshell, we're here to keep the riffraff away. Drunks, punks, and capless vermin are to be turned away. Potential customers are to be permitted normal entrance. That is, after we pat them down for weapons. An unarmed man is a lot less likely to try to steal something with several armed guards around. Don't start any fights. I don't care if some jet junkie just assaulted your mother. We're here to promote violence elsewhere, not start it here. Lastly, don't abandon your post. We're getting paid to stand next to this door, not talk to someone down the street or head to the casino. That goes double for any thoughts of splitting with that gear. Every now and then, some young punk thinks he can run off with Van Graff property. Trust me, the rifle and armor are nice, but they're not worth your life. Other than that, relax. There's usually some eye candy coming and going from the Wrangler over there at some point, so the view's not too bad.
All right, stay here, use the gun, wear the combat armor. It's like, do I have to?
Settle in. You've got some hours left before your shift ends.
Yeah, I recognize that, and it's hot as hell, do you know that? It's like, there's no shade here. This stuff is itchy.
Here comes
it's like
a winner. I'll let you handle this one.
Okay. Drunks, punks, and capless vermins, you say? Well, right now you look like you're all three of those. Or maybe two. You don't look drunk.
Hi there. Is this where I can pick up a laser gun?
I stand corrected. Yeah, get out of here. You're drunk.
Fine, I'm going. I'll take my business elsewhere.
More like he's going to the Wrangler for another drink. You watch. Another one coming. You're on.
Okay. Well-dressed. Doesn't look drunk. Or doesn't walk like he's drunk. Yeah, you might have some caps.
Hi. I was, in the area and thought I'd stop by to look at your weapons. Can I go in?
First off, it's an excellent choice you've made because we have some very high-quality energy weapons, and soon you won't even be thinking about those old guns of yours. Yeah, you can go in, but we're gonna have to search you first.
Fine by me.
He's clean. See? Not so hard, is it? Heads up. Looks like we got another customer.
Nice, spiffy, fancily dressed, probably has some money.
Howdy. I just done broke the bank over at the Wrangler there and thought I might peruse your fine wares. Maybe lighten my purse a little?
Story checks out. We'll need to check you for weapons first.
Now hold on here. I'm not packing any heat. Ain't my word good enough for you?
No. It's like, I don't, in a word, no. I don't know you from Adam.
If that's the case, then I guess I'll go spend my money elsewhere.
Wow. You're a real people person, aren't you?
Well, what did you want me to say? Yeah, go on in.
Looks like the guy's headed this way. Don't screw it up.
look, you said turn them down. It's like, if they don't want to get searched, then it's not my fault they're going to go somewhere else. It's like, that's the requirement of doing business. You said it yourself. Somebody in traitor gear. Okay, could be a traitor. Could be just some guy who mugged somebody off the road. Either way, it's a chance for us to earn some money, right? Simon, that's your name. I'm definitely not forgetting it. Because you are worth my time.
Hey, looking for something to replace my old revolver. Mind if I head in?
Yeah, sure, after we search ya.
That's not really necessary, is it? I already told you I got this here revolver, right?
Okay, but check it out. It's like, yeah, I have this laser rifle. I also have a Tesla rifle, an assault carbine, a Gatling laser, a few bricks of C4, some newly purchased energy weapons like a cannon. Yeah. Now, do you have something to hide?
You gonna ask me questions all day, or are you gonna let me in?
Well, I'll keep asking until you start answering.
Damn, I knew this wasn't gonna work.
What? Hey! That was not the best shot I wanted.
What in the hell do you suppose that was about?
Hell if I know. He had some C4 on him. And a revenge note. Hello, what the hell does that say? To whom it may concern, if you are reading this, then I am likely dead. I can only hope that I have managed to take out some of those thrice damned Van Graffs in me. My family deserves that much, at least. I'm guessing this is,
Don't clean this up. No one's going to want to shop here with the corpse out front.
Oh, okay. Yeah, fine, I guess.
This I do not need today. Keep your head straight, rookie. Things are about to get interesting.
Oh. Might that perchance be Pacer? You know, the guy who had a little tiff with us?
Hey,
hello.
Simon, how's it hanging? Looks like you've got a little helper today.
What can I say? Business has been good lately. We can afford to help.
Good to hear, buddy. So is the boss lady in?
You know she is. Why don't you go in and say hi?
Nah, I got some rounds to run. But do pass along that I'm always thinking of her. Actually, I got a better idea. Make the new hire tell her. You'll do that for me, won't you?
What the heck is with your voice? It's like, is that a thing?
I'll be sure to pass it along. Why not tell her yourself?
I would, but I tend to distract the boss lady a little too much. She can't help herself. Anyway, I got things to do. Later, Simon.
Way to keep your head, rookie. There's hope for you yet.
I messed up once, and even then I didn't really actually mess up.
It's just about closing time. Let's go see the boss about getting paid. Oh, I'm gonna need the rifle and armor back. Boss's orders.
So? What do you say? How'd I do?
Simon's been telling me how it went. Let's do a quick recap. You had a little bit of a hard time following instructions, but
what?
Didn't do too bad overall. Here's your pay.
Unfortunately,
no. I found someone else with a little more experience, and he'll take over the position starting tomorrow. However, another task has come up that I could use some help with, assuming you're still interested in making some money.
Look, I follow the instructions perfectly. Just because I didn't kowtow to some random guy who won the lottery is like, that's not me not following instructions. Fine, keep talking.
There's a deal that we've been working on for a while now, and the buyer would like a sample of our weapons. I need you to run a package out to a discreet location that the client has chosen. Sound good?
I can do that.
Good. Here's the package. I'll mark the location on your map. The buyer said they'd be in town for quite a while, so there's no rush. That said, try not to dawdle. This client could mean big money for us, which naturally means big money for you.
Van Graff package. Okay. Did they let me... They let me keep my weapons. Oh. You couldn't have done that earlier so I could sell you all this crap and... It's like I gave you 20,000 caps. I could have sold you some weapons and I'll... Crap, damn it. All right. We have a package to deliver. We're a courier. and it occurs to me that for the first time, we've actually gotten paid. Guys, did you hear that? We got paid. It's like, for all this time, we've been doing jobs. And now, not only are we making friends, they're paying us. Imagine that.